The Menzoi, David Menzies, a renowned Toronto journalist, has had a terrifying experience. Assaulted, he was, at Dundas Square over the weekend. Nothing is being done about it. Hi, David.
Hello, Charles. Glad to be with you.
What happened on a beautiful Sunday afternoon when you and your nine-year-old decided to go to downtown Toronto?
Charles, it was an almost surreal event. I was with my young son, Sean. We were having pizza and bubble tea. It was a beautiful Sunday night, and I had a new Canon camera that I thought I'd test out. Now, Yonge Dundas Square, for people that haven't been to Toronto, it's kind of like Toronto's version of Times Square. Tourists with cameras everywhere, lots of neon signage, tons of ambient light. And I was shooting, you know, the signage. I was shooting my son near the fountain. And all of a sudden, Charles, a woman wearing a hijab comes running up to me, and she's semi-hysterical. She's screaming, "We are Muslim. You do not photograph us." At that point, I said to her, "I beg your pardon, but I'm in a public place, and I can photograph anyone who I please." The funny thing is, Charles, two of her friends were in the full burqa, you know, face mask. You couldn't even identify them if you tried. It could have been anybody under those garments. Well, the next thing I know, and I have it documented on film, Charles, is she punched me right in the face. And then the next thing I know, I mean, you're in this like dazed state where you can't believe what's happened has happened. I'm surrounded by about 20 men. They appear to be Arabic. Some of them were speaking Arabic. And one of them is persistently saying, "Just give me your camera and we'll let you go." Now, I don't think the Best Buy extended warranty, Charles, covered, pilfering by a mob as a way to cash in on the warranty. So I was terrified, not necessarily about my camera, not for my own personal safety. I've been in rough situations before, but I had my nine-year-old with me, and there was no way in hell these bullies were going to harm a hair on his head.
Not to put up the stop sign too early, because I want to give you a chance to tell the rest of your story. But folks, in case you're just tuning in, this wasn't happening in Tahrir Square, Egypt, during a democracy riot. This was happening in your country, my country, our country, Canada, this past Sunday evening in downtown Toronto. Go ahead, David.
Yeah, it could have been one of those places, though, Charles. I mean, if you had a movie shoot, it would have passed the sniff test. I burst through the mob in a panic with my son in tow. And there were about four or five police on bicycles at the corner of Yonge Dundas Square. I went up to an officer, Tom Ragel, and I said, "Sir, I have been assaulted and I want to press charges." Now, the most endearing part of this story, Charles, is a couple in their 50s came up to us, and they're originally from Syria. And he said to the officer, "I saw everything. Everything he's saying is true. And what's more, I speak Arabic. I understand what they were saying, and it wasn't very nice." Well, so far, so good. But then, Charles, my spidey senses started to tingle. Right off the bat, PC Ragel and his colleagues are interrogating the witness, and they're saying, "Well, when you say he was hit, was it a closed fist? Was it an open fist? Back of the hand? The forehand?" And I'm thinking, wait a minute. I was punched. Well, what does the severity have to do with it? Then, after he's finished with us taking our statements, Charles, the woman is still there. He goes up to her. Now, Charles, this woman is still, after all this passage of time, absolutely hysterical. Phlegm is coming out of her mouth. She's swearing. She's screaming. She's tearing up. And I'm thinking, good, the constable is going to experience firsthand what I just did 10 minutes ago. Well, after he interviews her, Charles, here's the shocker. PC Ragel comes back to me and he says, "I interviewed the woman and there'll be no charges laid." And myself and the Syrian couple, we looked at him stunned, and I said, "Why?" And he said, "Well, I believe her story," which is to say, Charles, that when she lunged out at me, she was merely trying to knock the camera out of my hands. She wasn't trying to punch me in the face. My face, you see, got in the way of her fist.
All right, now you had the two witnesses who spoke Arabic. The cop decided that he wanted to believe her story. He could have simply charged her and asked her to tell the story to a judge, and a judge could have done what judges get paid to do, make a judgment, right? But that's what you were expecting.
Oh, absolutely, Charles. But I mean, listen to PC Rigel's logic. If I saw somebody walking down Yonge Street wearing a Montreal Canadiens cap, and I said, oh, how dare he does that in Toronto, are you telling me I can run up to him and swing my hand and knock that cap off his head? And, oh, if I miss the cap and I connect with his nose, no harm, no foul? This is preposterous.
I don't think he was pursuing any logic at all. I don't think he was talking about property crimes versus physical crimes. I think he was just looking for an excuse to call it a day, to not do the paperwork, to not have an incident of multicultural morass, whatever you want to call it, because I don't think there's any doubt here. I don't think any objective person watching this would have any doubt that if you had done this to her, if she was taking pictures in a square and you were in the square and you rushed her and charged her and hit her camera and hit her, I don't think there's any doubt at all that you'd be charged. I mean, do you have any doubt, David?
Oh, absolutely not, Charles. This is yet again, we've seen it so many times in this country, whether we're talking about Caledonia, whether we're talking about what happened in this city 2 years ago when the Tamil Tiger terrorist supporters commandeered the Gardner Expressway and nothing was done by the police. We have seen it time and again, political correctness trumping the rule of law. And when that happens, that's a dangerous slippery slope, Charles.
Well, it's just you know, in the preamble in Canadian Common Sense, it's talking about these people who are just defending their property, defending their families, defending themselves, and they're being charged. And here we've got a case, and there are many others. People can email us with stories that they know of in their own neighborhoods of people who are assaulted, and the people who are doing the assaulting, doing the attacking, are not being charged, whether it's for political correct reasons or other reasons. But you've had a beef for a while with the chief of police in Toronto, Bill Blair, and you've at times, and other people have at times, I've heard myself call him the chief social worker. I want to give you a chance to discuss what it is that you have specifically a problem with respect to the chief.
Well, the fact is, Charles, there seems to be one law for some people and another law for other people. I talked about the Tamil Tiger terrorist supporters. If you go to Gay Pride Parade, all of a sudden on that weekend, Charles, the public indecency laws go out the window. Full frontal nudity is completely ignored by the police in this city. And then we had the G20 last summer, Charles, where on day one of the G20, you had thugs, the black bloc, come down, dressed completely in black, smashing windows, setting police cruisers on fire, and riot outfitted cops just standing by and watching. And then on day two, Charles,
let's just be clear, ordered to stand by and watch.
Yeah, it's you always have to wonder about the chain of command, right, when it comes to this. And then on day two, Charles, suddenly, Dr. Jekyll turned into Mr. Hyde. These same officers turned on their own law-abiding citizens. Guys were being arrested coming out of pubs watching World Cup games. Journalists with full credentials were being taken to the Don jail. I mean, what is going on in this city?
I think from now on what will be going on is you'll be taking shots of seagulls, landscapes. That's what I think will be going on. From now on, that's what the Canon camera is going to be doing in David Menzies' hands. David, I know you got some makeup on to cover the wound. You did a great job, and good luck to you and your 9-year-old and all of the other 9-year-olds and their mums and dads in this country. Thank you so much for your story.
Thank you, Charles. And I just want to say thanks again to that Syrian couple that, despite that mob, and you know, Charles, I bet you these people came to this country to get away from that kind of garbage. They stood up and they told the truth.
And if you get more information when you submit that Freedom of Information Act for the police video, you'll come back and tell us more. Thank you so much.
You got it.
David the Menzoid Menzies.